I hope you all have enjoyed your tea. Was it good? Fine. After a long boring session, I will just take 5 and 10 minutes to explain water board services. Water board services, that is Hyderabad Metropolitan Water Services and Sewerage Board. There are mainly 4 services. First, new water connection, wherein you apply for a new connection. Then, enhancement of existing connection, name change of the connection, and disconnection. So these are 4 main services. This is the screen from where you select the service. After selecting your department, these 5 services will be displayed on the screen. Application for new water connection, application for enhancement of existing connection, disconnection request, name change request. Fifth one is not a service, it's just an additional tool for making extra payment. So we'll select the first service, that is new water connection. Once you select this service, you'll be given a applicant info page wherein you have to fill the applicant details. On behalf of you, anybody can apply. Suppose that I want my friend to apply for me, he can apply. In the applicant detail, his details will be filled, but the owner detail will be mine because that connection is going under my name. I hope I'm clear. So if you have any doubt, please ask me. I'm sorry I'm not that good at Telugu, but if you want, I can explain to you as well. So,
next.
Depending upon the type of connection you are applying for, there are various documents which you need to attach. What I mean by saying this, that suppose that if you are applying for a connection wherein you are going for a white ration card. So in that case, you have to attach white ration card, it's mandatory. And if you are going for, let's say, commercial connection, the documents which you have to attach are different. So, in this red text, we have explained that what type of documents need to be attached for what type of connection. Now, there is one more big catch. Occupation certificate, is there or not, and the affidavit. Here is one catch. If the person who is applying for the connection and he is not having the occupancy certificate for that particular premises, then he has to give an affidavit wherein the department will be charging 3 times the normal tariff. Means the user has to agree that, okay, I'm ready to pay 3 times the normal tariff. But if he has the occupancy certificate, his tariff will be normal. So you have to check that whether occupancy certificate is there or it's not there. If it is not there, then the user has to give the affidavit. Now, this is the application form. After filling this form, it doesn't mean that you will get the connection. Once you submit your application along with all the required necessary documents, this application goes to the department. Now, department will be scrutinizing your application. Once your application is correct, they will conduct a feasibility study that for the place where you have applied, connection can be given to you or not. Feasibility study. After completing their feasibility study, the applicant will be getting the messages. After every process, every phase is completed, he will be getting the message that okay, now this phase has been completed. Let's say feasibility study is one phase, which is conducted by the department. The kiosk operator or the Mi Seva has nothing to do with that. It's totally department dependent phase. Once the department completes their feasibility study or the field study, the message is sent to the user on his mobile and on his email address. The fine, your application has been seen and field study has been completed. Now, there are only two possible cases for every application. Either his application will be rejected or his application will be approved. There is no third option. There is no third option. Only two cases. Either it will be rejected or it will be approved. Now, once it is approved after the feasibility study, a message is sent, a SMS and an email message is sent to the user that your application has the feasibility study is completed. Now you need to go and pay the demand order. Go to the next slide. Fine. Okay. Now, over here, this is the first payment page. First payment page means wherein you have to pay the processing fee and the statutory charges. Now, processing fee for different connection is different. Let's say, for example, white ration card, it is different. For domestic individual, it is different. For commercial, it is different. You need not to calculate, the system will automatically calculate and it will display on your screen. And that is non-editable, means 2000 rupees, it is showing 2000 rupees, you cannot increase it or decrease it. If it is showing 2000, it means that you have to collect 2000 rupees from the user. And this is only processing fee and it is non-refundable. If in any case the application gets rejected, this 2000 rupees won't be refunded to the. So now you have made your first payment. Here you are putting in the acknowledgement slip. Acknowledgement slip contains the acknowledgement number, the applicant's name, the service name, payment amount, payment reference number, date of submission. All the required mandatory fields are here. Okay. Now this is in a PDF format which you will be taking out and giving it to the user. Now, citizen can come to kiosk anytime and ask that what is the status of my application for new connection. Sir, if any doubt, you can ask me, sir. I'm here to help you.
The actual feasibility study is not known by the applicant.
No, sir. It is not known by him. It is the entirely department-dependent phase. Department people, they conduct their feasibility study.
There is not a feasibility.
Pardon, sir?
If there is not having the feasibility, they are supposed to be able to refund the money.
No, no, no. Good question, good doubt. If in any case, in the feasibility study, it is found that connection cannot be given, it won't be refunded. It's a non-refundable amount because you are applying for connection. Now, if there is no main pipeline over there, how the department will give you the connection? But for conducting that feasibility study, they have deployed their man.
Okay.
Two or three guys, they go to that place and they conduct, they measure everything.
Okay.
So two people are investing their 2 days' time. Who's going to pay for that?
It is a duty of department either to provide the connection to the
sir, department. Sir, department is not in charity, sir.
Department even not in charity. Without me, sir, then it is directly the approach to the connection.
Even in that case also, sir. Even in that case also. Even in that case also.
In such case, they will be approached with the concerned water supply person who is there. If there is a feasibility by oral inquiry, now they are applying. As a citizen, I won't lose my money. As a citizen, I won't lose my money. I approach direct to the concerned person.
Sir, in that case, you have to pay another table.
Even without connection, no one will pay under the table or over the table. That is a different question. I am asking directly only.
Yes, sir.
Feasibility, I can suppose we have a CPDCL connection. Feasibility report is there. The citizen will approach to the lineman, will get the feasibility and will approach to the visa.
Sir, in any case, from what may, feasibility study has to be done. It's a department dependent phase. Me seva or anybody is nowhere concerned with that. It's a totally department dependent phase.
As a citizen will approach to the key.